Hi everybody, Bud Brown here. How are you doing today? I wanted to talk with you in this lesson about certain nouns. In English, they're classified as count noun. Oops, I see I got some reflection in my glasses. In English, we have count nouns and I forgot what it's called, but I would call them non-count nouns. And that means like this. If you can count it like cars, one car, two cars, three cars, boys, one boy, two boy, three boys, or pencils, one pencil, five pencils, 10 pencils, pencils, boy, cars, those are called count nouns. You can count them. But there's some nouns that you don't count. You can't count, like money. Well, you can count money, of course, but I mean the word money. We have a lot of money. We have a little bit of money. But you don't say one monies, two monies. No. Same thing with, I remember now, they're called mass. I think they're called mass nouns. Well, whatever. Water, like, you can say glasses of water, but not one waters, five waters. No, there's a lot of water. There's a little bit of water, like that. Also, mud, you can't count it. And if I could think of any more before this lesson's over, I'll write it down or let you know. But anyway, the reason you need to know count nouns and non-count nouns is because when you ask how much is something, well, in English, it makes a difference how much water is there. There's a lot. How much mud is there? There's a lot of mud. But you don't say how much pencils or how much boys. No. How many boys? How many pencils? So if it's a count noun, you say how many. If it's how much something is, I mean, if it's a non-count noun, then you say how much. Why am I telling you this? Because in other languages, it's the same thing. For example, in Tagalog, if you say, Makano iyan, how much is it? But how many pencils? Ilan ang lapis mo? How many pencils do you have? Ilan ang anak mo? How many children do you have? So, makano means how much. Like how much money. Ilan, how many. But the way you say it is ilan ang anak. How many children? I know ang means the, but that's just the way it is in Tagalog. So, anyway, very quick, and I hope you learned something. Till next time, bye-bye. Ilan ang kapatid mo? Naintindihan mo ba ako? Naintindihan mo ba ako, sabi? Alright, naintindihan ka na, ha? Okay, sige. Bye-bye. Hanggang uli. Okay, sige. Bye-bye. Hanggang uli.